In what way do you mean on, predict who we date? How can it decide who we date?
Ah, well. So it can certainly make people available to you with a match percentage, for example. It can use your information to try and find somebody who is better for you based on what you're looking for. That says, actually, people who are the best looking don't necessarily come off as the most popular. And actually having people think that you're ugly can work to your advantage, which sounds incredibly counterintuitive, right? So there's a mathematician called Christian Rudder who set up a dating website. And on that dating website, you used to be able to rate how attractive people were between 1 and 5, slightly cruel section of the website, unfortunately. But you can compare that to how many messages people would receive. And he found that it's actually the people who divide opinion the most who end up doing the best, not the people who are just, you know, classic girl or guy next door.
So by divide, you mean the people that some would find very attractive
and some would find, think, well, absolutely looks like a dog's dinner, yeah.
So that would be the best?
Yeah, those are the people who do the best. But it's kind of interesting because when people choose a profile picture to go on online dating, they try and pick the picture where they had, you know, like the day they had the loveliest hair or their skin looked the nicest, or they try and make themselves, you know, look the most attractive and minimise any flaws that they have. But actually it's the opposite of the type of thing that you should do. Instead, you should play up to whatever it is that makes you different, because really quirky things end up doing really well. So, in fact, actually, your earring, there we go, perfect example.
That would be a good thing.
Yeah, so people with tattoos do really well on online dating, and people with piercings, people with, you know, anything that's sort of quirky and a bit different about you, makes you stand out.
He used to have a ponytail well. As well, you know.
Really? Well, there we go, perfect. But the reason is that people who are messaging you are thinking about their own chances as well. So if they think that you're really beautiful, but that everybody else in the world is going to find you attractive, they imagine that there's loads of competition and you know, just what's the point in them getting involved?
Should one be, I don't know if, I mean, I feel, what is this math? I don't know, but should one be proactive?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So this is a really nice example, actually, of a mathematical framework of some equations that you can use to prove something that then actually ends up making sense back in the real world. So if you can imagine that you've got a group of single people in a party, now you can sort of split that party down the middle and say, okay, perhaps some people are going to be proactive and approach, you know, the object of their desire, and other people perhaps are going to stand back and wait for their choice of suitor. And in that framework, you can prove mathematically that the people who are proactive will always, always, always end up much better off than the people who sit back. So even risking humiliating rejection and all of the drama that goes with that, if you approach people and are proactive and go out and get what you want, you will end up with the best person who'll have you. Whereas if you sit back and wait for people to come to you, you'll end up with the least bad person who approaches you.
So you would be able to mathematically predict that now you will get an applause?
No.
Thank you very much.
And the reason is because burglars get to know the layout of your house. They get to know where you keep your valuables. They get to know the escape routes and so on.